so dangerous. My whole entire unit is dangerous.
Breath, she's swinging it from right to left. With the wide cleft, be hot to death. Staying alive, you know only the strongest survive.
Presented by Sprite, the 2K Sports pregame show.
Hey, Ernie Johnson here with Shaquille O'Neal. We welcome you to 2K Sports. Tonight we'll see the Washington Wizards playing against the Atlanta Hawks. Taking a look at the Hawks, they struggled in this matchup last season. Only one win for them through four games. They'd like to make a statement tonight. And the season only just getting started. A lot of games left to play. Shaq, if you're a team getting going, what's your focus early?
Well, you have to look for that consistency in your play. You have to try to establish that dominance. And as a player, you have to understand your role. You want teams to come in already a little on their heels. You have to learn your opponents. It's time to prove what you are all about.
And with that, it's just about time for the tip. Let's get it down to Kevin Harlan.
At you from the Verizon Center in beautiful Washington, D.C. as the Wizards prepare to take the court. The Washington Wizards coming to this one following a loss to the Bucks, and that was a real body blow for them. They got taken apart both offensively and defensively.
Yeah, it seemed to me their three-point shooting was their own worst enemy in that game. Clark, I mean, even their wide-open looks weren't falling.
Yeah, and I'm sure when they think back on that game, Steve, their main regret is going to be that they didn't get away from shot early on. They kept going to it.
A look at Atlanta's opening lineup. Millsap at power forward with Horford at center. Teague and Korver in the backcourt. And it's Carroll in at the three spot.
Kyle Korver really keeps his defensive business. Great at running off screens. And you know, that's where he gets a lot of the shots. Even when he doesn't get the ball, he occupies the defense, which is so important for his team.
And Korver really trains so that he can sustain that energy moving off the ball.
That's one of the more impressive things about it. Not only his quick release, but the work he does prior to getting loose for those shots. It takes an awful lot of endurance, stamina, and mental toughness, Kevin.
And Wall, here we go now. Good work defensively by Horford. And here's Atlanta. They put up a nice win against Detroit the last time out.
And I think everybody who was at that game would agree it was their defense that really wanted for them.
Yeah, they were all over the place.
The floor. Here's Wall. Shot is off. And Atlanta will come the other way. Let's send it over to Doris Burke, who caught up with head coach Mike Budenholzer. Doris?
He talked about how they match up with a player like Paul Pierce, saying, you know, he's one of those guys who really does it all at a high level. Defend, score, you name it. I think defensively, we may look to double some and force other players to make shots. He's one of the greats. You enjoy the challenge.
And here in the first, closing in on 2 minutes play. Here's Korver. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him. Unfortunately, perhaps never more valued Clark than it is right now in the NBA. Kyle Korver, such a great signing for the Hawks.
Yeah, really a good one. I mean, his contract is front-loaded, running through 2017 for around the mid-level exception. And quite honestly, he's worth every penny, not just because of his laser shooting ability, but he's a hard-nosed, tough guy, professional in every way. And he just brings a winning presence to whatever team he's on.
Says he learned a lot of his basketball acumen from his mom, who was a terrific player.
No question.
Now here's Wall. Tough time getting anything going against the Bucks. He was a non-factor. And so he ends a trip to the line. Officials saw the contact and he'll shoot two.
John Wall at 6'4", 39-inch vertical leap, long arms to boot. He's a complete physical specimen when it comes to the point guard position.
And Wall, a blur, guys, in the open court. Perhaps, Steve, perhaps the fastest player in the league end-to-end. He is devastating in transition.
Yeah, he's so tough to stop around the rim, even in the half court. But when he gets ahead of steam going, he can get into the lane and then finish with either hand. So, man, he is tough to stop.
Here's Wall, following the basket by Al Horford. Here's his shot. It's good.
That was some skill there. Nice use of the
this one so far. And the whistle blows. It's going to be on John Wall. That's foul number two for him.
Well, he's got to watch himself now. I mean, that's two fouls already, and he can't afford another.
Wizards making a switch here. Miller's checked in. Stolen by Pierce. And he gets the bucket. Pierce has got 6 points.
That is up-tempo basketball at its best. So much easier to operate in the open court when a steal triggers the break.
It really does allow your offense to flow better. You can get out and run and get easy opportunities. Then everybody needs confidence.
Back to T. The feed to Kieran. From the stripe. Good. He hits the jump shot. Teague's got his first 2 points of the night. The Wizards have gone 3 of 5 shooting the ball so far. And here's Miller. Beal, that's for two. And a great assist by Miller. That one goes in. The Hawks have gone 2 for 4 from the field so far today. Here's Teague. And he wills that one in. Sinking right through off the back iron.
You know, he was smart to draw his man out to the perimeter. He's giving up too much size to be effective inside.
Agreed. As long as he picks his spots, his outside shot will be hard to block, no matter who's on
it. Now here's Beal. He saw him with 10 points last game.
And it is very dangerous to leave him open like that. Lucky break for the defense that he missed it.
T with the ball. And it's Miller picking him up. Korver, averaging 8 points a game. Millsap misses.
What appeared to be an easy 2 points just never materialized.
Miller kicks to Beal. Hits it from 3-point range. Beal's got 5 points.
You know, you look at the teams with the best 3-point shooting last year, some usual suspects emerged at the top. Surprisingly, the Wizards were right up there with some of the elite 3-point shooting teams.
Again, Millsap missing.
Wide open like that, he'll rarely miss those.
Here's Pierce, and there's the whistle. Foul hard on the shot. He'll go to the line. As you guys were talking about, the Wizards were straight from deep last season. Steve, in the top 5 in the league, shooting percentage from beyond the arc.
Yeah, they were very balanced. I mean, they didn't rely on threes a lot, but they were able to space the floor and punish teams inside or out, and that's what led that team to that playoff run last year.
Here's what Washington's going with right now. Tawan Blair, who's checked in for Gortat. Humphries comes in for Nene. And Porter subbed in for Beal. Wizards leading by 5. We've got 1:13 left to play in the first quarter. The kick out to Pierce. Knocks down the 3-ball. Pierce has got 11 points.
Boy, they've gone on this run, and ball movement has been a big key.
Yeah, they have the defense on the run right now because every pass seems to have a purpose. They're getting great movement, great spacing, and they're really lining them up defensively.
Here's Bazemore. 14 points from him the last game against Detroit. Scott can't get it to go. Isn't it gone? 6-10 from the field in this ballgame. Miller, the pass to Porter. Miller kicks to Pierce. Pierce with another miss. The Hawks trailed by 8. 4-on-3 as they bring it up. About 7 separating the shot and game clocks. Here's Matt, guarded by Porter. Blair kicks to Humphries. He feeds it to Miller. The pass to Pierce. It's good. It's Miller with the assist. Miller's got his third assist on the night.
Their offense has really come together immediately. They could run away with this game.
It's hard to imagine they'll be able to stay as hot as they've been so far, but if they can, watch out.
Domination in the first quarter. It's been pretty lopsided. Washington out in front. They lead by 11. And we'll be back in just a moment with the start of the second quarter.
This Wednesday, November 26th, John Wall and the Washington Wizards take on LeBron James and the Cleveland Cavaliers. Live from Quicken Loans Arena. Don't miss out.
The Wizards shooting their fifth and sixth free throws of the game.
Last season, there were a handful of teams jockeying for that final playoff spot in the East, and the Hawks were right there in the middle of it and ended up snagging the eighth seed and then scared the Pacers in round one.
And Bazemore kicks to Scott, and he goes up strong with one hand and flushes it down.
Nothing fancy there. Didn't need it.
Nope. His only concern right now, Clark, is getting the points on the board, and I don't mean style.
I like the simplicity, but there was some style there, Kevin. It was a pretty sweet one-handed flush.
The Hawks trailed by 10, and even 3-on-3 break. And there before you are the teams that have been absolutely red hot for the last 10 games. In fourth, the Wizards.
The thing I like is they're getting good shots every time down the floor, and it's due to their unselfishness as a team.
For Atlanta, they have been all four of their chances so far in this one.
And as a club, they're kind of in the middle of the pack in the NBA in terms of their free throw shooting, about 76%.
You know, you don't have to tell them what their free throw numbers are. I mean, they're well aware of it, believe me.
Free throw good, Matt.
Kelvin Mack came out of Butler and was a second rounder back in 2011. Really solidified his role as a backup point guard with the Hawks last season. And you like his sturdy build. He's about 6'3 and goes around 210 pounds. So strong enough to handle that position.
Looking at who's out there now for the Wizards. Horchak's checked in for Blair. And Bradley Beal subbed in for Miller. And Wall with the slam. Defense looking a little bit dazed now. A ferocious throw down there.
Not bad for a player of his size. Not bad at all. How about that spring coming out of those legs?
Ball's not loose. And it's out of bounds for the Hawks as Atlanta retains possession. And Mack, it seems, Steve, still adjusting to NBA three-point range. Best is a mid-range shooter, it would seem now.
Yeah, but last season, you know, big thing, Kevin, he cut his rate of turnovers, he had good court vision, and really a combo guard. I think if he can continue to improve, he's got a chance to stick around this league for a long time.
Trying to shoot. Here's T. Horchak with the block. They recover. About a minute and a half into the second quarter now. Now here's Wall. He's got five. Beal. And that comes off the assist by John Wall. That's 7 points here for Beal.
You know, there's no better sign of how efficiently a team is operating than their assist numbers. And theirs are fantastic.
It's just beautiful basketball to watch, Clark.
And Atlanta calls their first timeout of the game. Chance of the season for them to go up against this Wizards team.
And the season series between these teams, four games in all, starting today, it's going to go a long way toward determining how this division shakes out by the end of the year.
Damari Carroll's checked in for Atlanta. And let's get this update now from Doris Burke, who's across the way on the sideline.
Hi, guys. I had a chance to find out what Mike Budenholzer was discussing with his guys. He told them they should be dedicating themselves to hitting glass with everything they've got from now on, even if that means it takes them away from defensive transition. The second thing he talked about was working hard to get their shooters open. He wants them looking for those gaps on the perimeter and letting it fly whenever they find them. Being in the position they're in, probably a smart move to go to the clipboard and switch things up while we're still in the first half. Kevin?
Great. Thanks for the report, Doris. Nene, he's checked in for Chris Humphries. And guys, even though there's not a lot of history between these two teams, there still is at least a little bit of a rivalry between these divisional players.
You know, when you see an opponent as much as they do each season, there's always that possibility.
pickup of the offensive rebound. And once he gets his hands on it, you know it's going back up and back in.
Ball gets to Beal. And that goes off the assist by John Wall. Wall's got three assists now in this one. Inside.
Terrific job that time defending at the rim. I mean, it's not an easy task stopping that fella when he's headed to the bucket like that. Good job.
Horford against Gortat. In the game. Beal, that's for two. Another one falls to Washington.
John Wall, known for his athleticism and highlight view of plays, but make no mistake, he's a true point guard, one of the top playmakers in the league.
Teague against Gortat. Gortat with the block. And so it looks like the Hawks will retain possession here. Pierce is checked in for Washington. Play here in the second quarter. Just five on the clock. Here's Millsap. Here's Horford. And he banks in the lane. Horford's got six here in this quarter.
It's a slow start for him. He's starting to take off since we hit the second quarter, guys.
Got rebound number five here tonight.
Well, you know, that's one thing they've been doing extremely well. Corralling those counts.
Seems like not a whole lot else is going right for them.
Gortat with a screen on T. There's Beal with the three. Rebounded by the Hawks.
Really good offensive execution. Nice pick. Just couldn't get the shot to go.
Boy, you love to see that as a basketball purist. Guy setting a good screen and then getting the shot opportunity.
Horford kicks to Teague. Teague left side. And he finishes nicely on the layup. Teague's got six.
Boy, they keep hammering away at him inside, forcing that ball into the paint. Smash mouth basketball.
Yeah, it's a strategy that has served them well in this opening half.
No good off the front iron. The Hawks trail by seven. 50 seconds left now here in the second. Carroll picks the tee. And he was fouled on the way up. Two free throws now for him.
Jeff Teague, one of the quickest and most elusive point guards in the NBA. He's incredible in transition. Where he's really improved is in the half court. He's figured out how to carve up defenses off the river.
For the Wizards, Juwan Blair. He's checked in for Gortat. Humphreys comes in for Nene. And Andre Miller is subbed in for John Wall. And the Hawks will go for a different look here. Checked in for Horford. Beasley comes in for Paul Millsap. Tabo Cephalosha is checked in for Damari Carroll. And it's Kent Bazemore in for Kyle Brook. And good on the basket. Look at
him. We should thank the defense for those 2 points, really. Nobody paid him any mind there. And they can guarantee this is the last possession of the quarter if they hang on to it.
What they're going to do here.
T dishes to Scott. Back to T. And he uses the glass on the lane. Teague's got 10 points.
Took advantage of some shoddy defense there. They've got to at least get a finger on it.
Pierce for three. Oh, and he just knocked down the buzzer beater.
How about that? A perfect finish to the half. And then attack another. 3 points onto their lead.
And we finish one half of basketball. Wizards lead by eight. And time now to go courtside as we send you over to Doris Burke from the sideline. Doris?
Kevin, I've got Paul Pierce. And the truth, what's been the key to your efficiency tonight?
Well, I'm just
just taking my time. You know, I know I was going to pick up as time goes along, and I started getting into a good flow. So I got some good shots and just took my time.
Thank you so much. Back to you guys at the table.
Thank you, Doris, for that interview, and we'll see you back here after the break for the third quarter of basketball.
Everything's been going in.
Wizards leading by eight.
After a five-year absence from the playoffs, the Wizards were able to get back into the postseason. That's a big step for the franchise.
And now let's check out the lineups, courtesy of Gatorade, all fueled up and ready to go for the second half of basketball. On the court for Atlanta, Millsap at power forward with Horford at center. On the wings, Korver and Carroll, and it's Teague in at the point. Korver kicks to Teague.
To be an afterthought in the playoffs, but they did as well as any could have hoped for in terms of getting to the second round and pushing the Pacers to six games.
And Doris Burke has some for us. Hey, Doris.
Kevin, thank you. As you know, Jeff Teague is starting to enter the upper ranks among point guards in the NBA, and he credits Coach Budenholzer for a lot of his growth. Teague said, he always tells me to be aggressive. That is the only way I want you to play.
Seems to be pushing the right buttons for us. Thanks. And Wall kicks to Pierce. Korver, the pass to Nanette. Millsap with the steal. And here we go. Fast break. Korver's got it. That's good. And so Teague with the assist. Korver's had it bent down within single digits for the Hawks. Washington calls timeout. So with the Wizards, a good postseason run, taking care of business, beating Chicago in the first round. And then Clark put a scare into the Pacers in the second.
Exactly, Kevin. There was a rumor that some teams were trying to make it where they would face the Wizards in the playoffs, thinking they were weak and an easy opponent. Not sure if those rumors are true, and the Wizards certainly showed they're very formidable and will be good going forward.
Teague with the ball. He's picked up by Wall. That is his first foul of the game.
Al Horford, 6'10", 250, really a natural power forward if he has to play at center for his whole career. He's shown himself willing to battle bigger players inside, but I don't think he'd welcome a chance to switch back to the four spot.
He kicks it to Millsap. And that one is stuffed right through. Well, as far as the defense goes, but that is not what's going to keep them in this lead.
But from the other perspective, you can see just how much that dunk pumped those players up.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I agree, guys. I sense a little bit of a momentum shift.
Pierce pushes the wall. And another miss by Washington.
And for Horford, you know, able to scrap inside to overcome his lack of size defensively. His quickness is his biggest advantage. I mean, he's excellent moving in space, defending the pick and roll.
Here's T. Again, the Hawks good for two.
Strong here in the third quarter. That's 4-for-5 shooting for this team.
Wizards leading by four. Panay setting the pick for Wall. Dishes it to Pierce. And good. Coming off the assist by Wall. Wall's got six assists here tonight. Let's talk about Horford's advantages playing center. Certainly his offensive skills among those advantages.
Yeah, an excellent mid-range jump shooter. Ball handling, face up, draw opposing bigs further out than they'd like, but he's also strong enough and quick enough to get past them and get to the rim.
Here's Beal with the three. Paul Millsap with the rebound.
I don't know if it's just me, but he's looked a step slow since the start of the quarter. His shooting has really suffered.
Three-pointer, and he gets it to go. Millsap's got 5 points in the quarter.
I'll tell you what, he is so difficult to guard, especially on a shot like that one.
Ball with it. He has five. Here's for three, and he gets the bucket. Pierce has got two now from beyond the arc in the third for the Wizards. The Hawks trailed by seven. 1:58 left to play in the third. Korver. And there's Horford. That's good on the assist by Korver. And that's 10 points to Horford.
Boy, they are just destroying them in the paint.
You could say that again, Steve. The defenders just aren't aggressive enough down low.
And here's Wall. Averaging 13 points a contest. That is good. And it's 29 points for Paul Pierce.
He has really put his foot on the pedal this quarter, doing a tremendous job leading their offense.
Korver with a screen on Wall. Here's Teague. Steps back and frames the jump shot. Teague's got 16 points.
Now, if you can't get around your defender, sometimes the best way to get a shot off is to go to that fadeaway.
Well, to get those big in-conference wins, you've got to be able to adjust mid-game, and the Hawks did that very well last season. Third quarter of game.
And a new group getting ready to come in for Washington. Tawan Blair, he's checked in for Gortat. Humphries comes in for Nene. Otto Porter Jr., he's checked in for Pierce. And Miller's subbed in for Bradley Beal. Wizards leading by three. And for the Hawks in the East, guys, finished as the eighth seed in part because of their ability to adjust after the hit.
Yeah, they end up with 28 wins in the conference. A lot of them came from their ability to come out strong after the break.
They've clearly been the better team on the glass. It hasn't necessarily translated to the scoreboard yet.
But you feel like it's going to reward this team at some point. They've got to continue to maintain the energy.
How about that fantastic finish and the aggressive move to
him? Trying to send a message, Clark, with that slam, I think.
Well, that's how you send it. Two hands and hammer it down.
Now by 10 seconds separating the shot and the game. Down to five on the shot clock. Wall gets the ball. And again, Washington, no good. And the foul called on Tawan Blair. That's his first foul. Here's Bazemore. And again, it's Atlanta.
This has been a different kind of game here in the second half. I thought both clubs were slow in the first.
Question, but they're really going at it now.
Coming up next Monday night, December 1st, Dwayne Wade and the Miami Heat take on John Wall and the Washington Wizards. Big time hoops coming your way.
And as we conclude, take a look at our State Farm assists of the game.
Well, this is what you talk about when you have the offensive play coming together based on tremendous passing. It's the rhythm and flow that occurs that makes this a beautiful game.
Chris Humphries is out there with Portland. And it's Miller. And there's Blair. And it's Wall. And it's the one. That's the group on the floor right now for Washington.
One of the oldest plays in basketball made that dunk possible.
That's right. A terrific screen right there, Steve. Allowed him to lose his man and rock it to the rim.
Now, don't you love to see players working together in that fundamental play? Fun to watch.
Chris Humphries, one of the lone veterans, Steve, last season on a rebuilding Celtics team.
Well, he was really a salary cap piece in that trade that brought Garnett and Pierce to Brooklyn. The minutes, limited by the needs of the Celtics to play younger players. But for the Celtics, they were actually better on both ends when he was on the court.
And the Beals checked in for Washington. And the Hawks making a change here as well. Horford's checked in.
I think we could be seeing a repeat of last night, fellas. It's just battling out there.
Wizards trailed by four. Miller kicks to Beal. Good. And Miller gets the assist. 17 points here for Beal.
And for Humphries last season, he returned to form with his mid-range jump shot. Very much value add. He's dangerous in that high post game.
Here's Baseball. The layup missed. Washington should be 53% from the floor. They're locked in. Beal's shot is good.
And this game is really heated up. I didn't think it could get any more high scoring than it already was.
Well, there's always room for more offense, Steve. You know that.
You talk about Humphries shooting a career year. Shot it at over 80%.
Tipped away. And it's out of bounds for the Hawks as Atlanta retains possession. So for the Wizards. Hortons checked in for Blair. Nene comes in for Chris Humphries. And Paul Pierce is subbed in for Porter. And Atlanta will go for a different look here. Paul Millsaps checked in for Mike Scott. Tamari Carroll comes in for Kent Bazemore. Kyle Porter is checked in for Sefolo Shah. And it's Teagan for Shelvin Mack. Washington trail. Second minute off the clock now in the fourth. Miller kicks to Pierce. Fires the three. Horford with the rebound. Horford's got his eighth rebound here tonight. Here's Korver. Here's Carroll. No good. Excellent D there from Pierce. The Wizards have gone 2-3 from the field to get the fourth quarter started. Miller, the pass to Pierce. Nice ball movement by Washington. And again, Washington, no good.
He certainly didn't take advantage of the poor defense, but they can't count on him to continue missing.
No, that's for sure, because this guy's too good of a shooter to miss that look consistently.
From deep three-point range, and a great assist by Miller. That one goes in. Miller's got his seventh assist here tonight. T dishes to Millsap. Double-digit rebounds now in the game. Horford kicks to Horford. Down with both hands. Game winding down, and they just keep changing leads.
Absolutely. I mean, lead changes here so far.
Steve, exciting stuff.
Yeah, this is a fun game to watch. Which team can kind of extend a lead and make a couple of big plays here to kind of seize momentum. We'll see.
And Washington making a change here. Ball's checked in. Let's go quickly over to Doris Burke for an update.
Hi, Kevin. Randy Whitman was just going over the plan with his team. He is not happy with their perimeter defense, saying, guys, way too many open shots for them beyond the 2-point line. We've got to press up closer and try to crowd them off the arc. Guys, we'll see if they got the best.
That is in the gym range, partner. Kevin, he can pull up and knock it down from anywhere. You hear me? From anywhere.
He's firing the three.
Atlanta calls timeout. Nice game. Great performance by Paul Pierce.
He's been locked in from deep. They're giving him too much breathing room and definitely paying the price for it.
The Hawks trail it. Here is Korver. Passes to Kirk. Six on the shot clock. Here is Korver. He's covered by Beal. Korver, no luck.
Looked like he rushed that one. As the defense was out of position, he was wide open. He couldn't take advantage. But the drive to the bucket was nice. Finger roll finish. Beautiful.
The Hawks drilled by four. Horford sets a screen for T. Here's Millsap. And that comes off the assist by Jeff T. T's got three assists now in this one.
They're doing their best to erase the deficit here with some smart passes and some good shooting. I mean, those two things go hand in hand. You're going to make shots, and the passes have to be on target and on time.
Well, kicks in the net to the paint. Here's Beal, and he uses the glass on the left. Beal's got 11 points here in just the second half.
Another pass put right into the shooter's pocket, right in the
steal. Pass to Wall. Beal dishes to Pierce. Now here's Wall. Back to Pierce.
From town to town.
Harrell with the rebound.
Kevin, just enough presence to bother that three-point attempt there.
Well, for a guy that shoots like he does, I'd say that is an easy look.
Seconds left in the fourth. Millsap cuts, and he has brought them to within 2 points.
And that is the shot of the game.
Well, he's got the guts and courage to take it, and the skill to make it.
Beal, the pass to Wall. 16 seconds left during the fourth quarter. Nails the triple.
I mean, they've been in charge of this game all the way through.
Here's Teague. Three from the inbound. Knocks down the trifecta.
This is great. Three-pointers going down quickly at both ends.
Yeah, it took them no time to answer back on that possession.
Deal with it. There's the dish to Nene. And they foul intentionally. They're going to have to do that now. Again and again, they're not in the penalty yet.
Yeah, you got to freeze the clock. That's the enemy in this situation.
A few misses at the line, and they're in good shape.
Goal! You can always depend on him to put the pass right on the button.
And so it's Washington who's straight by with the win. It was tight, but they managed to come up with the win.
Now, nobody wants to lose a close game, Kevin. It's much better to win those tight ones.
Chance now to send you over to Doris Burke, standing by on the sideline. Doris?
Well, Bradley, in a game that's so closely contested like this one tonight, is this the type of competitive game down the stretch that you live for as a player?
It always is, because it's just, that's just the competitiveness of the game. It was a great game today. Down the stretch, you just always want the ball in your hands, and it should always be a pressure situation. You should always live for moments like that.